In this lecture, we will address the third test type, which is white box testing. Let's see the overview of white box testing. White box testing derives tests based on the system's internal structure or implementation. Internal structure may include code, architecture, workflows, and/or data flows within the system. What you need to understand here is, during white box testing, code is available to the tester. And there are different types of white box testing, which we will discuss in Chapter 4 in detail. Now the question comes, where can we perform white box testing? It is performed at component or component integration testing because code is available at this level. The next question is how to measure white box testing. This is done by measuring structural coverage. Let's understand what is structural coverage. Structural coverage is the extent to which some type of structural element has been exercised by tests and is expressed as a percentage of the type of element being covered. Here we have one word, structural element. Structural element is referred to statements and decisions in the code. If you have this as an example, then this is called statement, and this is called decision. In white box testing, we can calculate coverage for component testing or component integration testing. The coverage for component testing is calculated by dividing number of component code tested by a total number of components multiplied by 100. The coverage for component integration testing is calculated by dividing number of interfaces tested by total number of interfaces multiplied by 100. Before we end this lecture, let's have a look into the last point. White box test design and execution may involve special skills or knowledge, such as the way the code is built, how data is stored, for example, to evaluate possible database queries, and how to use coverage tools and to correctly interpret their results.